10243, poems from the unpublished Book of Blues. You just tell the guys when to start.
I would like them to play behind me while I'm reading.
Oh, sure.
Can you hear me while they're playing?
Yeah.
Book of Blues. I see the backs of old men rolling slowly into black stores. Lion-faced, mustached black men with army weathered brown hats stomp on by with bags of burlap and rue, talking to secret companions with long hair in the sidewalk on 3rd Street, San Francisco, with the rain of exhaust plicking in the mist you see in black store doors, petting trucks, plopping, vastly city. Third Street, market, to lease, has a washed down tile entrance, once white, now caked with gum, of 100,000 feet of passers who didn't go straight on, bending to flap the time pap page on back, with smoke emanating from their noses, but slowly like old lantern jawed junkmen hurrying with a lump wondrous potato bag through the avenues of sunshine, came bending the spit and shuffled a while there. The rooftop of the beat-up tenement on 3rd and Harrison has Belfast painted black on yellow on the side. The old Frisco wood is shown with weather-beaten rain boards, and a washed-out blue bottle once painted for wild commercial reasons by an excited seltzerite, as firemen came last afternoon and raised a ladder to a fruitless fire that was not there. So is Belfast singing in this time, when brands forgotten, taste washed in, rain the gullies broadened, everybody gone, the acrobats of the tenement who dug Belfast, divers all, and the divers all dove. Ah, little girls make shadows on the sidewalk shorter than the shadow of death in this town. Fat girls in red coats with flap white-out shoes, harried Mexican laborers become respectable in San Francisco, carrying newspapers of culture burden and packages of need, walk sadly reluctant to work in dawn, stalking with not cat in the feel of their stride, touching to hide the sidewalk. Black shiny last night polished shoes hitting slippery with hard slicky heels to slide and fall, but wet crack! Kids with thick lips and black skin carry paper bags meaninglessly. Don't bother the cat! His mother yelled at him yesterday, and now he goes to work down 3rd Street in the milky dawn, piano rolling over the hill to the tune of the English fifers and some white of mine. Bric-a-brac, pliers on your back, mic-mac, kidneys in your back, ball, boo, oranges and you, lick-lock, the red-faced cock, oi, yal. He yawns to lal, la la, milung. The weary gray hat, peacoat, ex-sailor, marining meekly, hands a poop a pocket, face lips, Oh, Mosey! The long, fat, yellow eternity cream of the third straight bus, roof swimming like a monosyllabic, armored mosasaur swimming in my primordial windowpane of pain. Alas, the kid is worried. His pops astray. What to say to well-dressed ambassadors from death's truth? Pimp-like, rich in the morning slick, or sad white caps of snowy seamen in San Francisco gray streets, arm waving to walk the Harrison Cross and earn later sunset purple. Just dig that sad old bum. No money, presuming to hit the store and buy his cube of oleo for 8 cents. So in cheap rooms at AM 3:30, he can cough and groan in a white tile sink by his bed, which is used to run water in and stagger to in the reel of wake up middle of the night flophouse nightmares. His death no blacker than mine. His toast just as well buttered and on one side. There's no telling what's on the mind of the bony character in plaid work coat and glasses carrying lunch, stalking and bouncing slowly to his job. Or the beauteous Indian girl hurrying stately into Marathon Grocery, run by Greeks, to buy bananas for her love night. What's she thinking? Her lips are like cherries. Her cheeks just purse them out. All the more to kiss them and suck their juices out. A young woman flees an old man, Mohammedan prophesy. And she got avocados anyway. The furtive girl looks over her shoulder while unlocking the door of the tenement of her man, who with big Negro, Arkansas, or East Texas oil fields, Harry Truman hats, been standing there on the street all day, waiting for the cold girl, bending in thin coat in the wind. And Sunday afternoon drizzle. Step on it and get some bread. But Papa's got to get some sleep tonight, and the Chinaman's on his bed. No hunger and no whittles neither, dearie, said the crone to Edwin Drood. Okay. There'll be an answer forthcoming when the morning wind ceases shaking the man's collar, when there's no starch in it, and Acme beer runs flowing into dry gray hats, when, dearie, the pennies in the palm multiply as you watch. When whistlers stop scowling, smokers stop sighing, watches stop looking, and women stop walking and worrying coats. When gray beards grow no more, and pain don't take you by surprise, and bedposts creak in rhythm not at morn, and dry man's bones are not pushed by angry, meaning, pelvic, propelled legs of reason to a place you hate. Then I'll go lay my crowned body on the heads of three men hurrying and laughing in the wrong direction, my idol. Thank you. Love is an automaton sounding like a machine through the stop keyhole. Young men go faster than old men. Old men are passionately breathless. Young men breathe inwardly. Young men and old women wait or wail. Cause there was a sound of slapping when the angels stole come, and the angel that had lost lay back satisfied. Hungry adult red face with tight clutch, traditional time, briefcase in his paw, prowls placking the pavement to his office girl's rumpled skirt at 5 o'clock shadows. Angrily, I must insist, that phony Negro sea captain with a battered coat who looks like Charlie Chaplin in a movie about now, filmed in the air by crews of raving, rabid angels drooling happily among the funny, fat cherubim, leading that serious, hard-jawed, sincere Negro stud in at morn for a round of crimes, is Lucifer the fraud. Besides, little girls worry too much, but no one will hurt them except the beast whom they'd knife in another life in the as well east as west of Bethlehem and do of it much. Rhetorical Third Street, grasping at racket, groans and stinky. I have no time to dally hassle in your heart's house. It's too gray, I'm too cold. I wanna go to Golden. That's my home. I came a-wearying from Eastern Hills. Yonder Nabatake recessit. The eastward to Aurora rolls. Somewhere west of Idalia. Or east of Rusted Falls, one. Lost a black-haired woman with thin feet and red bag hanging. Used to walk down Arapahoe Street in Denver and make all the cabbies cry. And drugstore ponies eating pool and rem sacks sob. To see so lovely all the time and all so nice and young. Shaw, pause Ford, got lost in the depression. He drove over the divide and forgot to cleave the road. Instead put atomic energy in his machine and flew to find the gory clouds of rocky torment far away. And they fished him out of Miner's Creek, more dead than Henry, and a whole lot fonder, partner. Clack of the wheels, my freight train blues. Third Street I seed and knowed, and under ramps I writ the poems of the punk who met the Fagin who told him, punk, when walking with me to roll asleep and drunk. Don't wish you was back at home in your mother's parlor, and when the cops come a-blastin' with loaded 45s, don't ask for gold or silver for my purse. Its milk and hassle will be strewn and scattered in the sand by an old bean can and dried-up kegs we'd have sat and jawed on. Roll my bones in the mortuary, my terms and deeds of mortgagery, and death and taxes all wrapped up. Thank you.